finally got it done.
Hello there. There's some very stormy weather on the cards over the next couple
of days.
Sounds
like the weather's gonna be pretty bad.
Across the southwest of England and southern Wales, spiraling around the area.
This we've got
pressure. It's not just going to be windy, but it's going to be pretty wet too over the next 48 hours or so.
I got some brochures from the guy with the sheds and everything. I've chosen the shed that I'm going to go with, but I'm not going to show anybody. But I have got these. These are the greenhouses. And so Marjorie's got to decide what it is that she wants to have from them. I particularly like that one. But yeah, so we'll leave that up to her. So today we've got to go and rescue a trailer and see if we can right a tractor. The wonderful people that I got the fence off of decided that they would buy themselves a tractor and a trailer to go and cut down and collect their own wood from a forest, from the woods. So yeah, they bought themselves, I think they bought themselves that little Renault that was down at the auctions back in the summer, early summer. So yeah, we're gonna head down to the woods and see what they've done, because they called me last night and I was like, well, I can't come and do it now, so you'll have to wait. I'll come and do it in the morning. But unfortunately the weather has been pretty bad for the past few days. We've had rain and rain, and now we're expecting some really bad winds. But typically with the weather forecast, they don't always get it right, do they? So yeah, we've got the international, the little international sorted now, so that the PTO shaft has all changed, we've got a new one of those in there. It's all serviced, everything's been done, so really now it's just a case of sorting out the bodywork, giving her a good paint job, and then we'll see if we can sell her and get some money, or maybe do a deal for a tractor or something, machine. So here's the old farmer, and they've done a pretty good job of pulling that down, haven't they? I don't know what they're going to do about the old stone barn. I think that was listed. So whether he's going to have some kind of conversion done on it, if he can actually have a conversion done on it, I don't know. So, yeah, we'll see what happens there. So we head down here, we've got Dye's Fields on the left there, and I've got to help Dye. Because his wonderful field has decided it doesn't want to work, and it's blocked the door to his shed, and he can't get his other old field out, and he's got a flail mower rented from the dealers, and because they've got it in special for him, they're still going to charge him if he doesn't use it today, which I thought was really kind of them. So we've got to get his field done for him with the flail mower. So we'll be doing that this afternoon after I've done these logs. So we'll go through the ford here. It's looking a bit high today. I think we're in for some really bad times with this weather. We'll just have to wait and see, I suppose. We never can tell. So I think they said it was down in the woods, down here. Okay, around here, and then there's a wood, a small wood on the left. So, oh yeah, I see. Oh, wonderful. Well, that's a cracking job they've done there. How did they do that? Well, let's have a look and see what room we've got. What have they done? I reckon he's clipped that tree, ridden up it, gone round, and flipped her on her side. That's what that looks like. How did they get the trailer off? Beats me. So, we really want to push it away from that tree. How are we gonna attack this? Pull up the reverse round. We'll try and slide its front around a bit, I think. Let's make sure we miss the axle. Yeah, let's check it. Yeah, that's good, right. So if we gently lift and then just spin it around, spin on the wheel. There we go. I reckon that should just about do it. Yeah. Okay, and then what can we do now? We really want to get on the cab if we can. Can we get around here? No, it's too tight. Okay, well, back round then. All these trees. If we can get on the roll cage, we clear it? Yeah, we can get on the roll cage with the form, and then we can tilt and slide as we go. Yeah. I think that's what we'll do. We'll try and get it on the roll cage. Lift and then just tilt the forks as we go so that it kind of slides it, and we don't want to punch it out glass on the other side because it's not been broken. So we'll just go in nice and gently. We'll just get one fork on it, I think. Here we got it. We go up and gently tilt the forks down as we go. Don't fall off. Go on. Is that gonna stay? That's gonna stay. Okay. We'll just give it a little nudge. Hey, there we go. Success. Haven't damaged anything, have we? Nope. That's a tidy little tractor, really, isn't it? I quite like it. Silly little thing. Right. Tip them down. And then we'll get their trailer on. And we'll take that up to their yard. up there. Lovely. Okay. So we'll leave that there. I'm not even going to try and start it. We'll let all the oil run back into the sump, because it would just be a stupid thing to do to try and start that now. So we'll do a nice little ride back up to their yard. I do love it around here. Absolutely beautiful countryside we live in. Back to just coming up past his house. We nearly bought one of these houses. When we bought our house before the one we're in now, one of those was on the market at the same time. We nearly bought one of those instead of the house we had, because I wanted to, that they came for a bit more land than what ours did that we had. And I was planning then on possibly putting in a shed or something like that, just to have a little bit of farm storage. I wanted to get a vintage tractor. But we decided to go with the other one because it was cheaper, and at the time we just didn't really have the finances to be able to afford it. So we did what we did, but where we are now, we've got old Ted's house and his workshop and a little wood and half a field that we got that we didn't even know we were getting. This hill is steep. Come on, old girl, we can do it. Yes. Brilliant. So we'll go around here, go around here. Oh, look at those weeds coming up in the fields. We're going to have to get into them. Have to get in there soon. No need for an appearance from them. We'll have a bit of a better look at the farm now. Look at that. Yeah, there's the old stone shed in there. I'm intrigued to see what happens about that. Take a left here. Past the horse yard. Patrick's caravan over there. Wonder how safe that is in this type of weather. I'm pretty sure I didn't want to be in it. There's the cornfields, the maize fields that we did. Here we go. We'll just drop the trailer off. I think we'll stick it in there. So we'll just back it up. And then we can drop it off. That should do it. Lovely job. Right. Now we shall head to the dealers and get the flail mower for Di. Here we are at the wonderful dealers. There it is. Well, I presume that's it. We'll back up to it. Don't think I'll put it on. I'll just run in, double check. Yep, that's the kitty. So on she goes, PTO in. Yep, dinky little thing, innit? Right, so field he wants to in was the one that we were in at harvest when we were putting the header and everything on the combine. And he's got to do it because I think he said it was set aside and it needs to be cut. And I'm pretty sure it's something to do with the fact that the council, because Dye's farm is a rented farm, the council have been on at the Crown that it needs tending to. I don't know what it's got to do with the council, and it doesn't actually look that bad. So what do I know? I've not had to deal with the Crown or the council and things like this before, but he needs to do it, so we've got to do it. So we just get as close as we can to the edges. I think it's pretty narrow though. I think we're going to be here for a while. And to be fair, it's a little bit too wet to be done, but again, if they're going to charge him, whether he uses it or not, we just as well use it. Get it done. And then it's all sorted. Take it steady because I'm not sure what's in these sites. I don't know why he doesn't just put some crop in it. He must be getting a fair amount of money for having it set aside. So I'm pretty sure they get subsidies for doing strange things, but never mind. Who am I to judge? I'm just John Palmer, the farmer. Oh, I forgot. We're on this steep hill, aren't we? I shall have to go side to side rather than up and down. Get that gate closed. We shall crack on. We'll be right back. What on earth was that? Oh, I hope I haven't broken the mower. Oh, let's have a look then. Well, let's see. Oh, what's that? That's my flask! It's my flask I lost in the summer. Well, we're nearly finished. At least I found it. Not that it's any good anymore now. Never mind. I've got a new one. Quite sure that David is going to have a bit of a chuckle about that though, when he finds out. Well, there we go, that's done. So I think we'll head down into Di's yard. We'll go and see Di and find out what he wants us to do with the mower. I wonder where he's going to put it in. Or if he's going to leave this. I don't understand any of this. This leaving fields and doing other fields and. It's far too complicated for my liking. You either put a crop in, or you don't put a crop in. That's how I feel about it anyway. Let's see if he's in. He should be. His car's here. Hello, Di. It's a wonderful day for dancing in the rain.
How do, John? That it is. Did you manage to get the field done?
Yeah, it's all done. What did you want me to do with the mower?
Oh, yes. Could you put it into the shed next to all the chicken stuff?
Yes, I can do that.
Thank you very much, John. I really appreciate your help.
Not a problem. Right, so we will back her up into the yard and we'll drop it off in the shed next to the chicken stuff. What chicken stuff? Where are we? Oh, there's some. Oh, chicken stuff. That's not much chicken stuff, is it, really? Anyway, let's get it off. Lovely. And we shall head home. And see what else we can. Oh, we can start on that international, get ready for some paint work, I think. Let's go.